Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to actually put I want to put this tank floor in, and it's made out of 1/8-inch mahogany, so I'll get that get those dimensions from the plans here, get that all squared away, and I'll get you can guess how many I'm going to make. I'm going to make two. That way when I get to the next wing, I'm all good. I don't have to spend time making those things. So so let me get some plywood out, and maybe I'll get the wing kind of out of the way for the moment so we can get the I think I'm gonna flip it around. It'd be easier for me to work off the other end of the bench. So I'll get that done and off we go. All right, so our size is 14 by 21 7/8. Well, I'm going to make sure we're square here. It's good and square. So, find that pencil. 14 inches here. So we're 21 7/8. And then we have a 3.5-inch radius in the corner. Hey, man. All right, to the bandsaw. All right, so let's check the fit here. Now we'll find out if we get centered up in here or how that actually gets set. Yeah, so it just basically centers up in the whole bay here. I'm curious about the very front edge, if I can tell. Yeah, it looks like it sits back a little ways from the front edge as well. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a quarter inch away. So I'm gonna put a quarter inch there, and I'm gonna put a quarter inch here. I'll show you what I did. I just wanted to run. I'm gonna go with that because that's something that's easy to control, so just drop that down. And we'll put a quarter inch there, put a quarter inch here against the ribs, slide it over. Alright, so I'm gonna go with that. And now I'm gonna take my pencil. And I'm going to mark these diagonals so that I can come in here and draw these lines so I know exactly where to hit the staples, where to hit the members with the staples. How about that? Alright, we'll need those quarter inches in there. Then I'm going to flip it over. All right, this is our glue side. All right, glue, 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 staple, staple, staple. Staples on this side, glue on that side. And we'll be all set. All right, so that's what there is to getting set up for that. Now, now it's just a matter of getting some epoxy. Oh, you know what I have to do? I got to put this back in and mark on my cross members where the epoxy is going to go. So let me dye real quick here. All right, now I'll mix up some epoxy, I'll be right back. So it slid on me a little bit, so I'm gonna have to pop this out. The epoxy's pretty slippery. All right, so that's what I've got time for today. And thanks so much for checking out the video. I do really appreciate it. And it wasn't a large scope today, but it is something that's gotta get done. And the next step is actually gonna be to build the fixture that's gonna hold the leading edge plywood while it's wet, and then while it dries in the form to kind of take the shape. And but you don't have to worry about all that, I'll show you. And so we'll be building that fixture and getting it ready to start putting some plywood in there, and let's get this leading edge done. So there's a couple other steps involved. I have to get the varathane that I'm using on the whole inside of the leading edge D-box area. And then you have to make marks on your plywood where all the ribs are, and where it's gonna cross over on the spars, and you actually tape those areas off, and then varathane the whole inside of that, then you peel the tape off, and you have a nice dry place to put epoxy. So yeah, that's kind of where we're headed. So yeah, thanks so much, and I'll catch you later.